is.
We're in Baltimore City looking for robbery suspects. Through investigative techniques, they knew that they were here at this hotel. They had coordinated that once the suspect vehicle was brought up by the valet driver, that they were going to pinch the suspect vehicle in, turn their lights on, and announce that they were making an arrest. Once the valet driver came in and the suspect got into the vehicle, we believe that the suspect realized that the officers were pulling up. The officers turned their lights on, got out, announced to freeze, get out of the car. At that time, the driver of that vehicle crashed into the back of a police car that had its lights on, and it's the Suburban that you see behind me. After the vehicle hit the Suburban, one of the detectives was standing by the orange cone marker that's behind me. The suspect vehicle went directly at that detective. That detective discharged their service weapon. The suspect vehicle then continued, careened off the silver vehicle that you see behind me, and went north on South Calvert Street. That vehicle has since been recovered. This is a long time for us to continue our investigation, and there's a lot more that we have to get into, but right now we know that none of our officers were injured. We do not know if the round struck the suspect or not, and this is part of an ongoing investigation.
Has the suspect in custody?
So we have one person in custody, but we do not have the driver of the vehicle that aimed towards that officer. We do not have that person in custody.
These were robbery suspects?
Correct. Robbery suspects in Baltimore County that were in Baltimore City, and through investigative techniques, our Baltimore County robbery detectives were down here to make the arrest.
And they were at this hotel over here?
Correct. They were at this hotel over here. They knew the vehicle that they were looking for, and when the valet driver brought that vehicle around, is when our arrest team went in to make the arrest.
What part of the county were the robbery suspects?
So it's multiple robberies that were in Baltimore County. I can get you more information as the exact amount of robberies. But right now, this is an ongoing investigation with a lot of work that needs to be done. We're still looking for that suspect driver, that vehicle. Although the vehicle's in custody, we do not have the driver. So this is still an active scene and an ongoing investigation.
And Baltimore police aren't involved.
Go one more. Baltimore police are not involved, which is why I'm here actually doing the talking.
Where did you apprehend the other suspect?
Here.
Here at the scene?
Correct, here
so
at the scene.
So he never got into the vehicle that fled?
Correct. Right now, we believe that the two suspects came out. We think that maybe they saw the officers approaching. One suspect went back into the hotel. The other suspect went into the vehicle. And that's when that suspect ran the back of the police car that had the lights flashing and then drove directly at the detective. The detective discharged his weapon, then careened off his silver car and went north on Calvert Street.
Where was the vehicle located?
Right in front of the hotel. So the valet driver...
No. Once the vehicle fled.
I'll have to get that information for you.
So one suspect was apprehended?
We have one suspect in custody. We're still trying to figure out the relationship between that suspect and part of the investigation. But we have one suspect in custody. We're still looking for the driver of that vehicle, the one that aimed toward the officer.
Vicki, given that it happened here,
correct,
and it involved your investigation previous to this event, wouldn't it have been a situation where you would have called the city and said, hey, can you do this?
Or not necessarily. No. So oftentimes if we have robberies that happen in the county, felonies that happen in the county, our task force and our officers are allowed to come down into Baltimore City to effect that arrest. There were no city officers involved in this arrest right here. It was strictly a Baltimore County project that started off in the county and then went into the city to make the arrest. So there were no city officers involved.
Do you think they're going to take a look at it as far as could we have done this differently to maybe not have it get a little chaotic? Is there any other way the arrest could have been effected?
Well, it could have been effective if the suspect would have stopped and listened to commands. It could have been effective if the suspect had listened to the officers that were marked in police gear and had their lights on, but instead that suspect decided to run the back of a police car and drive directly at a police officer.
Was there any evidence the suspect is armed?
That we were looking into that.
And no, any evidence that, well, second part of that question, if armed, fired the weapon at all?
So the only weapon that was fired was by our Baltimore County detective. As to whether there another gun, I do have to look into that. I don't have that confirmed yet, but I do have to look into that.
Was that detective undercover? Did they have body-worn camera?
So for body-worn camera, great question. Let me look into that. I do not believe so because they're typically undercover detectives, but I will look into that. But they are marked with police, Baltimore County police. The lights, the red and blue lights, were on the vehicle that you can see flashing behind me. and they identify themselves as police officers and order the person out of the car.
But do city police do the investigation into the shots being fired by your officer?
Correct. The city police would take over the investigation for the officer discharging the weapon here in the city and the driver going towards the officer. They will have that part of the investigation. Yes, sir.
Talk about the course of the investigation in terms of the officer firing into the vehicle was warranted.
I'm having a hard time hearing you. Say a little louder.
How you guys go through the process of determining if the officer was warranted in firing?
Right, so as you know, there is a very strenuous process anytime an officer discharges a weapon. It goes through a criminal review, it goes through an administrative review, it goes through a firearms review, it goes through an internal affairs review. So there is a lengthy process that has to be done to go through this entire investigation, including the discharging of the weapon from the officer.
So what happens with those officers now?
So right now we have to go through an entire process. We have to notify their family. We have to make sure that we take the weapon away as part of the evidence. It's just a very long process that we do to make sure that the officer gets debriefed. They have to talk to their family. They have to talk to their FOP attorney. They have to talk to, at some point, investigators. So again, this is very early in the process.
They're on leave.
Why were the suspects at this hotel?
I can't hear you.
Why were the suspects at this hotel?
I do not know.
So they are on, the officer's on leave?
They will be on standard administrative leave pending the investigation.
One or both?
One. I'm sorry. One.
Anything you can tell about this officer?
No. Right. We have to make notifications. This just happened at 2:15. Mm-hmm. I haven't even confirmed if this officer's family is aware of what's going on. But it's important to know that the officer was not injured. We do not know if the round struck the suspect. Okay. That's still part of the investigation.
Okay.